I'm not sure if this counts as an alien or not, but I definitely saw something I can't explain at all about 5 years ago and have been dying to tell the story. About 5 years ago, me and two other friends were on our way back from Warped Tour in Maryland. For those that don't know, Warped Tour is a heavy metal slash hardcore concert tour thing. We were being driven by one of our friends' moms because none of us had a car that we could drive yet. It was almost night. The sun was still out, kind of, and it wasn't dark yet, and we were driving on a two-lane highway that had trees on either side of the road, and a median in the middle of the lanes. Basically, some creature ran out from the trees on the other side of the highway, jumped the median, and sprinted towards the trees on our side. We almost hit the thing, and our friend's mom had to slam on the brakes, and everyone in the car was screaming our heads off. Not because it was a look-out-for-the-deer situation, but because this was the scariest-looking thing I've ever seen. It was black, had long, gangly limbs, and moppy black stringing hair. This thing moved so weird, I can see it clearly to this day. It even galloped so awkwardly, did not run on all fours like a deer, or anything of that sort. When it jumped off the back two legs and landed again on the back two legs before coming down, and then galloped across the road. Everyone in the car said the same thing, which was, "What was that thing?" To this day, I am convinced it was a demon, or an alien, or an escaped medical experiment. It was large and terrifying, and the way it moved was unlike anything I've ever seen in my life. I wish I had more details, but sadly, that's all I remember. I've asked my friends and that friend's mom about it numerous times and years after the fact, and it still gives everybody shivers. This is the craziest UFO phenomena true story, and it came from my dad. 1960s in Ethiopia. My dad is just a child, 9 years old at the time, playing with his best friend Gabriel after school. They were playing in the fenced backyard of my dad's house. My dad turns his back for a second, then turns to look back at his friend, and Gabriel is gone. It's important to note that my dad and Gabriel were from the top 1% of Ethiopia's ruling elite. My dad's father was Minister of Interior of Ethiopia, and Gabriel's father was a 4-star general of Ethiopia. The backyard Gabriel disappeared from had 10-foot bricked walls with armed guards patrolling on the outside. A couple of hours pass. His parents, my dad's parents, and guards are searching, but no Gabriel. 48 hours pass. Now, there is a nationwide search for this important general's kid. It's on the news. Police are searching door to door, describing him and what he was wearing when he disappeared. He was wearing at his private school uniform, white shirt and brown pants. Helicopters even searched the countryside looking for him. Still, nothing. A month passed, then two, then four. People start losing hope that he would ever be found, and think the worst. Exactly 6 months to the day that he disappeared, Gabriel appears back in my father's backyard. He was still wearing the same white shirt, private school uniform, and it was clean. He looked exactly the same as he did when he disappeared. This is where it starts to get weird. Once they had confirmed that he was okay, they started asking where he had been. He said a couple of nice men took him on a trip. He was in a white room that glowed, and other children were there from different countries. He said he was surprised that the nice men, who looked like white guys, could speak Ethiopian, and he could understand what the other children were saying, even though they were not Ethiopian. The white glowing room had no windows, and the doors disappeared into the walls. There were buttons on the walls, and if a kid pushed them, a bed would come out of the wall. He said he was then all of a sudden in a city that was glowing, clean, and cars were flying around him. He said there was people, but they looked really strange. Like us, but different. One nice man was still with him and took him to a tall building, where he said he had to stay there for a while, but showed him a room that he could use for entertainment. Gabriel said that he could push a button and the room itself goes places. An open field, the beach, The room itself even flied. He said after a couple of hours he was taken back to Ethiopia and appeared in the backyard. He thought he was the only one gone for a couple of hours total. No one believed him. In Ethiopia, being a super religious country, most adults around him thought he got possessed by the devil. Gabriel even was forced to see a priest and get the evil spirits out of him. My dad still kept in contact with him throughout their lives. Gabriel got a doctorate in physics, and I believe he currently works in Holland. Mine happened probably back in about 95 to 96-ish. At the time, I was a pizza delivery guy. I was out on a delivery, and after the delivery, I was returning to the store. While driving along the highway, I noticed three still lights, almost in a row, way off above the horizon, since it was evening and it was dark. Stars were visible. First thought was that they were from planes for the airport, as they were way brighter than the stars that were out. They only looked still because I was driving on the highway, and my mind was playing tricks on me. Over the course of the next few minutes, as I was continuing down the highway, I noticed the center light started moving up. It continued into the shape of a triangle. I continued to try and keep an eye on triangle of lights in the distance as the whole thing moved towards the sky. I eventually lost eyesight of this thing, behind trees and whatever else, and made it back to work. I was utterly confused by the whole thing. I didn't tell anyone because I figured they'd think I was crazy. I kind of even thought myself I was seeing things and making things up. I don't know why I remember this part. All of this happened about a week before the Super Bowl. Might have been the Friday before Super Bowl. I'm unsure. All I remember is that before the Super Bowl, I was watching Sci-Fi Channel. Some show was on about people who had seen UFOs, whatever. I was always skeptical. Then, they did a segment on numerous sites of triangle-shaped lights, and they started showing clips of the few examples that people had caught on video. It was exactly what I had seen. Never saw anything since. No one else reported any strange sights or lights that weekend that I knew of. Of course, I was a dumb kid in my early 20s, so I didn't pay attention to local news. But I'll never forget that incident. I saw a UFO up close. Probably from 30 feet away, tops. I'm pretty certain that it was of military design, though. I was out driving with my younger brother near a military base in Tucson, Arizona, probably not even 2 miles from my house. It was about 10 p.m. or so, and there were no cars on the road. I was making a left at an intersection, and right as I completed my turn, I heard it. Approaching from behind us was this vroom sound. Literally, the sound that they play as an effect for hovercrafts in movies. That was what I was hearing. It started out quiet, but got louder as the craft got closer. Since it was obviously heading above us, my brother leaned out the window and exclaimed, "What is that?" To which I responded by hitting the brakes. What I saw shocked me and had convinced me ever since. As I came to a stop, the craft glided above us, and I watched the wings detach like a transformer robot and lower themselves from the craft by about 10 feet. The wings, at this point, were supported only by two rods connected to the craft. There were two giant thrusters on each wing, as well as an even larger one at the bottom of the main body of the craft. The shape of the movement suggested that it was in some sort of VTOL mode. Because it changed into this mode, it swung around and did a complete 180 over a two-story building just ahead of us to our left, barely missing the roof with its wings. Then, it reconnected the wings, forming a triangle shape, and it boosted off back over our heads at an incredible speed. To further describe the craft, it had two modes as far as we could tell. One, where the craft is consolidated into a triangular shape and seems to be designed for quick horizontal travel, while the other mode allowed for VTOL movements. It could switch between modes like 5 seconds or less in this mode. It almost looked like the body of a stealth bomber, but with two sword-shaped objects underneath, and of course with thrusters facing like a 45-degree angle but they seemed adjustable. The whole thing was pitch black, and we would have never noticed it had we hadn't had the radio off and heard it approaching from behind. I can come back later with a... When I was about 12, my family bought a fishing cabin by a small river about 70 miles from our home. On our first visit to stay in this cabin, it was kind of a work vacation, meaning we were painting and fixing and stuff, as well as fishing. One of the people who lived near this cabin came over to say hi and introduce herself. During the course of her visit, she told us, "Don't be afraid of the purple glowing mist you will see. It's just from the UFOs and it won't hurt you." All of us kids snickered at this while elbowing each other, so my mom chased us off and apologized to the woman. She later yelled at us for being rude. Two nights later, we were out at night fishing with our father. The stars were amazing, looking without the city's lights pollution, and we were all pointing at different constellations and challenging each other to name them. My youngest brother pointed out to a perfect circle of about 7 bright stars and asked, "What are those called?" We all kind of froze and stared because, well, there's no such constellation, yet here it was. While we were looking at it, the stars took off differently and silently in different directions and vanished all over the surrounding horizons. We ran. Looking back, it was stupid to run. I mean, the things were already gone, but we were spooked, and we ran as fast as we could back to the cabin where my mother was sleeping. About half the way there, our dad overtook us and ran straight into the cabin ahead of us, slamming the door. When we get back into the cabin, he told us, "Just shut up and go to bed." He sounded angry, so we did just that. The next morning at breakfast, when we tried to talk about it, my dad angrily said that he didn't remember any of that and to stop with the stories. My sister asked, "Why did you run?" And he said that he was tired and wanted to go to bed. He was tired, so he ran? My dad can be a real goober sometimes. This wasn't the only time we saw things in the sky while staying there, but it was the most interesting. We tried on a few occasions to get pictures, but it was the early 60s, and cameras sucked half the time back then. At least the cheap kid cameras we had did. We were afraid to ask Dad's good camera for that. We only had that cabin for a few years when my dad suddenly sold it. We never could get him to talk about that night. He would firmly deny it every time we tried. Never did see the purple glowing mist though, and we looked for it. This actually occurred last week, on January 15th, 2016. I live in Outer Sunset in San Francisco. Around 7 p.m., I poked my head out the window to see if it was raining. It wasn't. I heard a loud aircraft overhead, which was several magnitudes louder than the planes that normally fly in the area. I looked to my left and saw a plane that appeared to be a commercial aircraft, but I noticed it was much larger, and the lights were super bright and creating large cones of light ahead of it. I remember thinking how neat it looked, being able to see so much of the craft and the area lit up around it with such a cloudy evening. When I tried to focus in on its lights, they flickered off, and I lost it completely. I could still hear it though, very loudly. About 10 seconds went by, and I see something come alight about 2 blocks to my right. I see a lot of commercial aircraft out there, but this was easily 4 to 6 times larger in the sky than they normally appear. The lights were strange too. I saw what appeared to be 4 white jet exhausts, and across the whole craft, they were blue and red lights and lines slowly glimmering. It moved much slower than regular planes and was visible for about 10 seconds moving north along the beach. It then vanished for about 10 seconds. Confused, I looked around to see if anybody else had witnessed it. Lo and behold, someone on the corner of my street who was riding their bike had stopped and was gazing up at the sky in the same location as the craft had been. I shouted down to them, "Hey, did you see that? What was that?" They turned and looked at me, looked back at the sky, and then back at me. Then, without saying anything, got on their bike and rode away quickly. I could still hear the craft, so I got out onto my roof and about a half minute later or so, I saw it come again from behind and slowly fly west out over the ocean until it vanished. I stayed on my roof watching and waiting to catch it again, but I didn't hear or see it. After about 20 minutes, regular aircraft began flying overhead per usual. My best guess is it could have been some sort of Let me preface this by stating that almost all of the encounters that I have witnessed have been with at least one other individual. The first two encounters happened on two consecutive days in 1997, and the numerous other encounters happened over the span of 90 days a year and a half ago. I do not recall being abducted. I have filed reports within an incredibly incompetent mutual UFO network. Back in 97, my buddy and I had just finished up our pizza shift at a joint. It was around 11 p.m. We were worn out and wanted to go get stoned. We were completely sober. Anyway, we drove out into a cornfield in the off year, so it was full of rye. We were about half a mile off the road. It was pitch black, and because of our vantage point, I could see headlights in any direction for a good mile. We were way out in the country, so no worries. My buddy starts breaking up the weed when I notice what I believe to be a truck headlight shine directly from behind, take a hard left, and disappear. My buddy didn't seem to notice, but I became frantic. I thought it was the cops. My friend thinks I'm messing with him and continues breaking up some really terrible brickweed. I recall looking at the stars, and one star in particular grabbed my attention. I can't tell you why, but it looked like your average star. Within 30 seconds, this star starts moving up and down, side to side, and in circles. I yelled in a panic, "What is that?" My buddy just gives a dismissive sigh, and then he looks where I'm pointing. For 5 minutes, the UFO continues to move in very fluid movements, making impossible maneuvers, and do so in complete silence. Without notice, this one object becomes five equally impressive star-like objects. They stayed close together. At times they moved in some kind of formation, and other times they seemed to move independently. Just as quick as they came, they fused back together as one. We were in shock, but we didn't feel like we were in harm's way. We were recapping what we witnessed, but that single UFO was still there. It wasn't moving too much. We thought things were coming to a close, but we were wrong. This time, the one object turned into at least seven objects. The way they moved and jerked around felt aggressive to me. My friend must have felt the same way, because he said he was starting to get nervous. I told him we should go. Embarrassed, I confessed that I knew it was there for us, and I became fearful. We haul out of there, and this thing follows us to the outskirts of town. The night after, me and the same buddy walked across my apartment complex to go visit with a neighbor that was about to grill some burgers. The sun was just starting to set on a humid midsummer afternoon. We knock on the door, and my neighbor lets us sit in. With him was his girlfriend, her sister, and some random guy that I didn't know. I go out back with Ray to chit-chat while he fires up his Kingsford grill. It's just the two of us, so I take the opportunity to tell him about the previous night. The stars are just starting to come out, and in my storytelling, I pointed out one just so Ray would know exactly what I meant. I'm still pretty much tripped out, so I'm fairly excited when describing everything. I'm almost done with my story, and I notice Ray looking at the stars that are just beginning to appear. I mean, this guy is looking around everywhere. It's like he became instantly paranoid. While I was in mid-sentence, Ray points to the northeast and yells, "Like that right there?" The goosebumps. He yelled inside for everybody to come out. They did so, and soon after, the same situation as mentioned starts to occur. It went on for a bit. It went on so long that everybody but Ray and myself went inside. We ate our burgers while watching this. Behind Ray's apartment was a field. 300 yards away on the other side of the field is a tree line and creek. On the other side of that tree line is another field. This object slowly descends towards the tree line, and I open the door and yell for everybody to come back out. We watch this huge fiery orb in complete silence land on the other side of that tree line. When we lost direct sight of it, we could still see the light through the trees. Right before the light disappeared, it became very bright. We all kept asking each other if this was real. And this is the part where some of you may lose it, but hell. After several minutes and at the end of all sunlight, nothing was happening. Everybody was in and out of the house. I remember standing in the front of the back door, talking to Ray's girlfriend in the kitchen. Ray, my buddy from the previous night, and the girlfriend's sister were outside. My buddy says, under his breath, and darts past me. The sister is right behind him. Ray shoves me in the door and almost falls on top of me. The girlfriend screams, slams the door shut, and locks it. We all back away from the door, all after our "what on earth was that?" We decided it was a four-legged, covered in brown fur, and tried to attack us. This apartment was a townhouse. We all went upstairs to get a better look. There it was, in the shadows. It was pacing around and keeping an eye out. This is when they appeared. They came out of the darkness. They were short at around 3 feet tall. Skin tone was grayish with a bit of Caucasian color. These were short grays, and there were several of them. Meanwhile, the animal thing starts to climb a utility pole. This isn't a typical utility pole. It has 6 or 8 transformers on it, and is H-shaped, and kind of low. When the beast starts to climb, I watch it shapeshift to a degree. It decides to perch on one of the crossbeams. It looked right at us, but its focus seemed to be on the ETs. It acted like a guard dog, for lack of a better words. The grays were clothed, and they had some sort of instruments. They seemed preoccupied by the field. They would look at us on occasion, but they were doing something. What exactly, I don't know. This went on for hours, and eventually, we all went and ran back downstairs. Every once in a while, I'd go check to see if they were gone, and as soon as it was all clear, I ran home. That was it. For the next 4 years, I pretty much believed it was random. And then after meeting my biological father for the very first time, my ex-wife jokingly brings up my UFO stories over dinner and wine. The crazy thing about this is I don't in any way believe in UFOs, even after having the experience, though I have no good explanation of what happened. I'm a pretty staunch atheist, and I don't tend to believe in something unless there's a reason to. I don't even trust my own experience, even if it was corroborated by others. But this one was really hard to shake off. I was riding home to the country one evening, rural Kansas, and had 3 other friends of mine in the vehicle with me. We were totally sober, because I feel like that matters, and we were about 20 miles or so outside of town on a country road in the middle of nowhere. It was about 11:30 at night, late enough that there really wasn't any other traffic on the road, but not so late that it was in the middle of the night or anything. I was in the back passenger seat, looking out the windows just into this dark farmer's field that has just a tree line that paralleled the road. All of a sudden, just behind that tree line, it's about 100 yards from us, I see blue lights flashing behind the tree line, and I turn towards my friend who's driving and tell him to slow down. We pull over to the side of the road and look out towards the tree line. At this point, the lights are directly perpendicular to our position on the road, but we were behind the tree line. At first, I'm thinking it's like an electrical substation blowing up or something. But then the blue lights change and start flashing in all kinds of different colors, becoming more and more rhythmic and bright, casting God rays through the dust over the tops of the trees. At this point, I had stepped out of the car and was watching as the God rays began to descend towards the eye level. Whatever it was behind the tree line was rising up towards the tops of the trees. At that point, my friend starts screaming for us to go. We jump back in the vehicle, and he takes off like a bat out of hell, flying down the road. The lights continued to rise until they were perfectly level with the treetops, and whatever was on my other side starts chasing the car, staying just out of clear view behind the other side of the tree line. My buddy pegged the car out over 90, It was a family car, and not very fast, and the thing kept perfectly alongside of us almost the entire way back to town, and then winked out just before we got there. We talked about it for an hour at a gas station just inside of town, and then decided that we wanted to go back and see if we could find whatever it was we had seen. But this time took dirt roads that paralleled the country road. So we'd been on the other side of the tree line. When we got back out there, we saw fire trucks all over the place driving slowly with spotlights aimed at the field, looking for something. They were canvassing a large area covering about 3 miles. I called the fire department to ask them about it the next day, and they said they had gotten reports of lights or fires from several people over a large area, but they were unable to find anything. To this day, I have no idea what we saw. I don't know where I stand on the whole UFO controversy, but I can vividly recall an experience from my childhood that I've never forgotten and cannot explain. I was maybe 10 or 11 years old. I distinctly remember it because it caused me a sense of terror, more pure than any I had had or felt since. My parents' house is out in the country, and my old bedroom is on the second floor, with 2 windows facing north and west, respectively. My bed was up against the west wall, just beneath the window. My dog Henry was sleeping with me that night. I woke up to the sound of Henry barking and found my room bathed in light from the window above my bed. I can vividly recall Henry silhouetted, staring into the light, barking her brains out. I jerked up and looked out, but there was only light. A crackly, humming, droning sound filled the air. I was disoriented and terrified, both for myself and for my dog, but all I could do was pull my blankets over my head and curl into a ball. I was sure Henry was going to die. I remember feeling sorry that I was too frightened to help. In my head, the clear thought of, "I don't want to die," repeated over and over, and I wasn't aware that it was the first time in my life that I had ever really not wanted to die. Like, it was the first time I'd ever genuinely felt that I was going to die. The experience ends there. I woke up the next morning with Henry in my bed. I immediately went to my parents' room and woke them up to ask if they had seen the light or heard Henry barking, but they hadn't. I wondered if I dreamt it, but I'd never had a dream so visceral before. All the fear I'd experienced up to that point became a lower classification. Now there was fear, and there was real fear. When I first heard about sleep paralysis, my mind immediately went to that night. It had some of the same characteristics, the terror, the vividness, the weird noise. But I wasn't paralyzed. I moved twice. Once when I sat up and peeked into the light again when I pulled my blankets over my head and hid.